Hi, I'm Dr. Alison Betz, a board-certified behavior analyst from the Scott Center for Autism Treatment. Welcome to the Autism Advisor Toolkit on Applied Behavior Analysis as a Treatment for Autism. I'll be providing a brief overview of applied behavior analysis here, and you can also learn more about this topic and others using our resources in this toolkit. First, please let me emphasize that you should use independent judgment and request references when considering any resource associated with the diagnosis or treatment of autism or its associated medical conditions. The information in this Autism Advisor Toolkit is solely for educational purposes and should not be considered medical advice. To understand applied behavior analysis, we must first discuss behavior analysis in general. Behavior analysis is an experimental approach, or science, that studies the behavior of organisms. The objective of behavior analysis is to identify principles or laws of behavior. In other words, behavior analysts are interested in figuring out why people behave the way they do. Applied behavior analysis, or ABA, is a branch of behavior analysis that uses the principles of behavior to solve practical and socially significant problems. One of the main purposes of ABA is to improve the quality of life of individuals. This is done by teaching appropriate behaviors and skills, as well as by reducing problematic ones. It is a common misconception that ABA is synonymous for autism treatment. However, ABA is much broader than that. Although ABA has been shown to be one of the only evidence-based treatments for autism, there is a large body of literature showing its effectiveness in areas such as organizational behavior, animal training, sports, and education, just to name a few. So although we will be focusing on ABA as a treatment for autism in this toolkit, I want you to remember that ABA is more than just a treatment for autism. It is a common misconception that ABA is synonymous with autism treatment. However, ABA is much broader than that. Although ABA has been shown to be one of the only evidence-based treatments for autism, there is a large body of literature showing its effectiveness in areas such as organizational behavior, animal training, sports, and education, just to name a few. So although we will be focusing on ABA as a treatment for autism in this toolkit, I want you to remember that ABA is much more than just a treatment for autism. While there is no known cure for autism, research has definitely shown that treatment methods based on the principles of behavior, or ABA, can produce lasting behavior change for most individuals with autism. ABA as a treatment for autism is often referred to as behavioral intervention, early intensive behavioral intervention, or EIBI, or behavioral treatment. Regardless of what it is called, ABA as a treatment for autism has been endorsed by the U.S. Surgeon General and the New York State Department of Health. In addition, it has become widely accepted among healthcare professionals and is used in many schools and autism treatment clinics around the world. To date, no other treatment has comparable evidence of effectiveness. Effective behavioral treatment for autism has several common characteristics. However, it's important to emphasize that it is not a cookie-cutter approach or a one-size-fits-all approach. A well-structured behavioral program is an individualized approach to treatment in which a qualified behavior analyst systematically and continually assesses the client's current skills, needs, family preference, and environment to design effective intervention. In addition to ongoing oversight by a behavior analyst, an effective ABA program will use a variety of behavioral procedures to teach appropriate and desired skills, as well as reduce problematic behaviors. To teach new skills using behavioral interventions, the target is usually broken down into small, manageable steps. Starting with simple steps that are developmentally appropriate for the client, The behavior analyst uses a variety of techniques to teach the client. As the client learns each step, a more complex skill or step is introduced until that target skill is mastered. One of the most critical behavioral techniques used to teach a new skill is positive reinforcement. Positive reinforcement involves presenting a preferred item or activity immediately following the target behavior. Positive reinforcement is used in ABA treatments for autism because learning does not come easy for individuals with autism. So we need to motivate the child to attend and respond to instruction. A good ABA program will often start with more extrinsic rewards, such as the child's favorite treat, but then systematically work toward getting him or her to respond in the absence of those treats under conditions that are more typical. Another critical component of an effective ABA program is the number of learning opportunities. A good program will incorporate an abundance of opportunities for the individual to practice the target skills across many different environments, with many different people, and with a variety of materials. This is often referred to as training for generalization and will help make sure that the individual can use the targeted skills in any situation in which it is needed. Finally, a good behavioral program will always incorporate caregiver training to teach those close to the individual how to support and practice the new skills. Despite the overwhelming evidence supporting ABA as a treatment for autism, many parents choose to pursue intervention methods for their children instead of or in addition to ABA therapy. If you decide to investigate or pursue other intervention methods for your child, it is very important to thoroughly research the treatment to determine whether it's an evidence-based approach and can support its claims with scientific data. For more information on how to determine whether treatment is supported by research, go to our Making Sense of Treatment Options toolkit. Research shows the earlier your child can begin ABA treatment, the better the outcomes. So if you suspect your child may have autism, don't wait to get started and contact a qualified licensed psychologist. If your child already has been diagnosed with autism, begin behavioral intervention as soon as possible. If you're not sure if you have a certified behavior analyst in your area, you can always ask your pediatrician or visit BACB.com. For more information on the diagnostic process, refer to the Autism Advisor topic on diagnosing autism.